2018. I was standing on the porch of my house when a convoy of dump trucks and wood chippers arrived and promptly began cutting down the 100-year-old elm trees lining my block. At the time, I was going to university, studying forest ecology, with a strong interest in leaving my prairie city to become a forester out west. If you don't know, a forester is a person charged with studying, inventorying, and ultimately deciding what trees can be cut down sustainably in a forest. So here I am, studying forestry to leave for the forest industry, when right outside my house, thousands of elm trees are being removed due to Dutch elm disease. On average, 8,000 elm trees per year in my city alone. And this got me thinking, where could these trees be going and what could they be used for? Fast forward a few more years, and I finished my university degree in environmental science. I spent 3 years as an initial attack forest firefighter and 2 years as a forester, both in northern Canada and on the West Coast. It was on the West Coast, flying over some of the most beautiful, pristine mountains in British Columbia, working my dream job as a forester, when that little question crept back in. Where do all those trees back home go once they're chopped down? And that little question, in that moment, drastically altered the course of my life. So, I moved back home to find some answers. And after several meetings, phone calls, emails, I finally put the whole picture together. And it wasn't pretty. It turned out all of those trees, thousands of trees citywide, went to the dump. I'm not going to lie, I was livid. I thought, what an absolute waste on two levels. One, after 100 years of service, think beauty, shade, water retention, even higher property values, those older neighborhoods would lose their charm without that old growth canopy. And we're just going to throw them out like garbage? And two, we weren't even going to try to utilize the wood for any better purpose. Everywhere I look, people are talking about green this, sustainable that. But right outside our doors, we are wasting an untapped, valuable resource and trucking it to landfill every single day. As I dug deeper and deeper into this issue, it turned out this wasn't even just a local issue. This was a North American issue. That deep feeling of injustice turned into more intrigue and passion on the subject. But after doing a few calculations, I discovered that we landfilled more hardwood trees than hardwood lumber we were importing. And that frustration came back. Let me say that again. We landfill, chip, burn, and bury more hardwood trees than the lumber we import. And not just in my city, but likely yours too. To give you a quick little wood lesson when I'm talking about hardwoods and softwoods. Softwoods are what we use to build our houses with. Think 2x4s from Home Depot. They come from coniferous trees like spruce, pines, and firs, and have softer wood. Hardwoods, on the other hand, they come from leafy deciduous trees like elms, oaks, and maples, and have harder, more valuable wood. Think hardwood floors, furniture, and interior trim work. I realized just being upset about an issue wasn't going to change anything. I decided I wanted to take that feeling of injustice, throw in my background in forestry, sprinkle in a lot of it of blind passion, and I could make the change I wanted to see in my city. And that's when I started Urban Lumber. When we look back in history, society was built on the resources we had around them. You had quarries producing bricks and stones out of local deposits, and you had sawmills producing lumber out of the trees from the surrounding area. Makes sense, right? Well, fast forward through the Industrial Revolution and into today, and we have monopolies formed coast to coast, hoarding our timber resources. Canada was such a vastly forested area, only relatively has a small number of gigantic forest operations. In Manitoba, we have 40% of our landmass as forest. That's about the same size in square kilometers as the entire United Kingdom. We have a lot of trees. Yet in this room right now, and I checked, we have fir from BC, maple from Quebec, and red oak from the United States. Now, I'm not anti-forestry. In fact, quite the opposite. when done properly, it can be a renewable resource. But what I'm here to tell you is that we can be sourcing wood from right inside our own cities. It's more environmentally friendly, and it's a better option all around. It just makes sense. In our city, for example, 15,000 to 20,000 trees are removed every single year due to decline, development, or disease. Half of these are due to Dutch elm disease, which infect our most iconic boulevard elm trees. The fungus that causes Dutch elm disease was accidentally imported here via log shipments in the 1920s. It quickly spread across North America, devastating the elm populations. American elm was once a major species component of forest from here, east to the Atlantic Ocean, and south to the Gulf of Mexico. Today, Winnipeg has one of the last and the largest intact American elm forests on the planet. And people think African mahogany is an exotic rare wood. Of those 20,000 trees removed every year, let's say just half of them could be used and sent to a sawmill. That's over 1 million board feet of lumber. To put that in perspective, that's 212 NBA basketball courts of hardwood, or 26,000 dining room tables. And that's per year in my city alone. And that is a lot of wasted wood taking up space in our landfills. Speaking of landfills, wood is biodegradable, right? So it doesn't linger in the environment like plastics do for hundreds or thousands of years. It sounds like a good thing on the surface. And that's correct. It's okay on the surface. Like when a tree falls on the forest floor, it decomposes slowly, and by doing so releases CO2 in a natural way. It's part of the carbon cycle. However, in an unnatural situation, like in a landfill, when these trees are buried and without the presence of oxygen, their route of decomposition produces methane, which is 80 times more powerful a greenhouse gas. It's the same reason we have composting programs, to keep organics out of our landfills and also produce a benefit. In terms of composting, that's soils for our gardens. In our case, it's using these logs, discarded logs, to make wood products. So how do we utilize these trees? Well, it starts with the removal process. Instead of chopping these trees into small chunks and sending through a chipper or into the back of a dump truck, we can thoughtfully remove these trees in a way to preserve them to send to a sawmill for a better purpose. The answer isn't what you're all thinking of when I say sawmill. It doesn't have to be these massive, gigantic operations with huge, massive equipment. It can be many small operations, even mobile sawmills. It can be everything from Bob in his retirement milling some trees on the weekends to small and medium-sized enterprises milling for the architectural or furniture industries. All major Canadian cities have strong markets for hardwoods, and all Canadian cities have problems with logs in their landfills. There's three ways that we can change this, not just here, but everywhere. Number one is cooperation. In order to recycle trees on scale, cooperation between cities, arborists, and sawmills is crucial. Cities, be open to public trees being utilized. These are the citizens' trees. You're just entrusted to do what's best for the public. Arborists, yes, someone other than yourselves may make a profit off the same tree that you were already paid to remove. But unless you're making a wood product, you don't get to have your cake and eat it too. And sawmills, it's up to you to make it as easy and accessible and pleasant so that companies and cities and people want to recycle trees through you and give back where you can. Number two, quality control, standardized quality control. One of the reasons urban wood hasn't truly taken off to its full potential is due to inconsistencies in both price and quality. But this is easily overcome. Lumber has been around an awfully long time. All the industry standards and rules for everything from moisture content to the grade of the wood are well established and easily accessible. It's up to the small-scale sawmill industries to adopt these rules to truly incorporate local wood into the market. And third, industry acceptance. Designers, architects, builders, carpenters, woodworkers, furniture builders, sticking to your normal swatch of oak, ash, maple, and walnut, without considering the abundant local species due to unfamiliarity, will still make progress in recycling our trees. These industries like to market themselves as, you know, very sustainable. Well, I challenge them to think outside the box and try using undoubtedly the most environmentally friendly wood in existence that's right in front of them. Aside from furnishing and styling our cities with local wood, there's an even bigger opportunity on the horizon where we could actually build our whole cities from our own trees. Buildings entirely made from wood in a recent and innovative method called mass timber construction is taking the building world by storm. Buildings up to 12 stories tall are now being built out of wood instead of concrete and steel. That's right, 12-story buildings made from wood, small pieces of wood, all glued together to form structural columns, beams, and floors. And it's greener, faster, just as strong, and ironically can be just as fire-resistant as concrete and steel. Just imagine new developments when they're taking down their trees for a new build. They could be building those new structures with the trees right from that site. It's a wild idea, but it's actually how we used to do it. The movement to use urban lumber has already begun. I'm doing it, and so can you. The next time you're out in your neighborhood, take a moment to observe and enjoy the trees in your neighborhood and ask yourself, do these belong in the trash? We have the knowledge, the resources, and the will to change things, but it's going to take a shift, an industry shift, on the familiar, common, imported woods. But guess what? Industry shifts to what people want and to what people demand. In our city, it's elm trees destined for the landfill that could be utilized. Find out what trees are in your city that can be used for a better, more sustainable purpose than a landfill. And you can do even more. For example, and I know, when you need furniture, the easiest thing to do is order that acacia wood top from IKEA. But just consider this. Those acacia trees are grown in Southeast Asia. They're going to get shipped halfway across the world to Europe to be manufactured. And if you live in North America, they're going to get shipped across the world again to get to your home. You could save all those carbon emissions and help your local economy by just taking one extra step in that process. Google your local wood supplier. They are the key to accessing the local woods in your community, and they can network you with the local woodworkers that can build whatever it is you need. By requesting urban local woods in any capacity, you're shifting us all back to common sense. Using, not abusing, our natural resources. Because trees aren't trash.